What's up, Kirill Pianskis here. In today's video, I'll show you how to control Tuya devices from Home Assistant. I will use this 4-inch Wi-Fi RGBW LED downlight from TuyaSmart, but you can use the same approach for any Tuya compatible devices out there. Let's start with some basic questions like, what is Tuya? This is an IoT platform that enables brands and manufacturers to provide one common solutions for their clients to control their products remotely. In other words, if you see on a product that is Tuya compatible, that means you can control that product from your phone using the TuyaSmart application, which is available for free in your smartphone store. You may ask yourself, why should I care to integrate Tuya device with Home Assistant when I can use the TuyaSmart app to control it? And this is pretty reasonable question. But at the end of the day, you may want to have all of your devices in one place so you can make better scenes and automations. For example, if you have many smart home devices from different brands like Philips, Samsung, IKEA, Sonoff, Shelly, and so on and so on, it's a lot better to control them all from one hub like Home Assistant. So I'll demonstrate you step by step how to integrate this TuyaSmart downlight, which is Tuya compatible with Home Assistant, and if you watch the whole video till the end, you will learn how to use the same method to control any Tuya compatible fan, switch, light, cover, air conditioner or heater. So, without further ado, let's go to the requirements. To complete this tutorial, you will need smash like button for the YouTube algorithm. Just kidding. But it takes only 2 seconds. Now seriously, you need Tuya compatible device like this nice light and working Home Assistant, but if you still don't have them, check this video. First, you need to connect your Tuya device with the TuyaSmart app, and I'll quickly show you how to do that.
The TuyaSmart Smart Downlight 14 watts RGB CW.
Now let's go to my screen.
The Home Assistant part should be very easy. I will go to Home Assistant web page, then I'll click on integrations and I'll search for Tuya. You can find here climate, cover, fan, etc. But this is actually, all of these are one and the same page, so it doesn't matter on which one you will click. It will lead you to this page at this moment, and this is the configuration lines that we need. And I'll just copy them. Next, I'll go to my Home Assistant and I have to add this copied lines in my configuration.yaml. If you are using Home Assistant, the new name is only Home Assistant, the previous name was has.io. You have possibility to install configurator from supervisor, add-on store. And here you can search for configurator. Where is it? Here it is. and you can install it from here and show it in the sidebar, and at the end you have it here. You have this menu here. From this menu you can edit your YAML configuration files. The other way is to go to your configuration folder and to edit the same file with text editor from the console, like this, for example. This is my configuration folder of my home assistant, and I can edit the configuration file from here. This is exactly the same as with the configurator. So it doesn't matter which approach you choose. The end goal is to edit your configuration.yaml file and to add these four lines in it. So I'll copy this again and I'll add these lines here. Now you have to change your username and password with the username and password from your TuyaSmart application. You can do this by directly typing your username and password here, or the better approach is to use secret. But wait a second, I will use this secret and then variable which have to be added in secrets.yaml file. Where is it? Here. I will use this approach because it's a lot better. You can share your configuration with someone afterwards without worrying. So this is the syntax that you have to follow in order to enable this link to your secret.yaml. You have to add this keyword secret and then the variable of your choice, and this variable, in my case, I will rename it to this, my Tuya username password and my Tuya username and my Tuya password. My country code I'll get from this link, countrycode.org. I'm from Bulgaria. My country code is 359. For United States, for example, is 1. United Kingdom. Okay. This is the telephone prefix of the countries. So, I will type there my country code, which is 359. And everything else I will leave like this. The next that I'll do offline is to add this my Tuya username and my Tuya password to my secrets.yaml. Next to these variables I will put the actual username, just like that. Imagine that is my secrets.yaml file. I will type the following: username at something, then the next part, password, my super secret pass. So this I'll add in my secrets.yaml file and I'll save it. That's it. It's easy. The other way is to directly type your username and password here. But again, it's not recommended. I will click save just to show you something.
Hey, if you're still watching, consider subscribing. I will post video weekly.
If I now try to open the configuration YAML from my terminal, I will see the same thing that I just added in configurator plugin. It's exactly the same. Now, the next thing is to restart my home assistant. I'll go to server controls, I'll check the configuration. Configuration is valid, so I will restart the home assistant. And I will fast forward it in order not to waste your time, as usual. Okay, home assistant is now restarted. I'll go to developer tools, then on states, and I'll enter light. Here it is, smart bulb light. Great, friendly name. Smart bulb supported features 3. How can I understand which are these features? Okay, that's what I need. Actually, I'll need to have this. Now, if I go to the home page of Home Assistant and then I click on Configure UI, then I can edit my light card. And here I can add additional, what was the name? Smart bulb, yes, smart bulb. Save. And now let me try to, yes, it's working. Let me show you, I'll turn this around a bit. So, if I click turn on, yes, the lamp is getting on and off. That's it. It's working very good and very easy. The only problem for me is that I cannot control the color. Maybe there is a way. I will have to read a little bit more. And if I understand how, I will add this in the video description.
Home Assistant integration with the Tuya compatible ZemiSmart downlight is now completed and it's working very well. This is my first Tuya compatible device in my house. And I wonder, do you have any Tuya devices in your home already? And if yes, are you happy with them? Or you plan to buy something? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below and I will promise to respond you back. Any sort of engagement on this channel does really help a lot with YouTube algorithm, so you make sure that you hit the subscribe, like and bell buttons if you enjoyed this video. Also, feel free to find me on Twitter by searching for this username. I'm trying to post there frequently. I really hope that you find this information useful and you can now control Tuya compatible devices like this downlight from Home Assistant. Thank you for watching, stay safe and see you next time!